mentor for today's session. He is head and senior consultant in Narayana Health Rabindranath Tagore International Institute of Cardiac Sciences, Mukundapur, Kolkata. Over to you, sir. Now you can proceed.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
All of you must be enjoying the...
Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon. So you must be enjoying the whole session. And I must say that whatever the plan or whatever the topics has been selected by our esteemed faculty as well as the Farz Academy, it will definitely help you all. And if I talk about the mentorship, I must say that this is the time when if you are going for the appearing in the exam, so there should be an orientation for last almost 6 to 8 weeks before actually appearing for this exam. And this is like that. So whatever practice you are doing in the day-to-day patients, seeing the patients and planning, management, all these things, so that should be much more streamlined. And most of the topic, whatever you have seen in the words, that will be covered. But that topic, the way they will put the questions, so in the part one, EDIC part one, it is basically a direct question as well as one is K-type, where there will be multiple questions, multiple answers that you have to select. So before going actually in the exam, you must see that whether A or K-type you are dealing with. And second thing, there should be some kind of practice. Practice means basically there are different type of modules that is being prepared by the for this year, European Society, that is usually we call it as S module or SU module. In that module, I must say that along with your common books, you must go through that S module. And in that S module, there are certain areas, you must underline those areas, because if during that study, you find that there are areas where you will see that there are sometimes footnote, as well as at the end, there will be some question for the practice. So these are very important, and the similar type of question you will actually face in the exam also. So each and every aspect of the aspect as well as topic of the S module you must go through, and along with that you will get some references. So please go to the important references, particularly the references for that. There are landmark studies also, you can directly be connected with the direct link from the test module, you can go to that area. So also go through that references. So this will I must say this will help you. And for that 6 to 8 weeks, you continue to, if you have one, you get someone, okay, who are also part of your examinee. So you can also have a discussion. So you can make a small group of 2 or 3 persons who can discuss in between, okay, during the time when you are not studying, you can discuss these questions and answer. So it is a some form of group study, you can say. So that is also very helpful. So, and about the topics, I must say there are certain topics that will be well covered in the EDIC, and you will get so many questions from these topics, particularly the cardiac topic, which is not very common for the your FNB or DNB exam, as well as our Indian that IDCCM or ISCCM questions, but it will be well covered. The cardiac, there are so many questions you will get from the cardiac aspect. So cardiology part should be very well covered, whether it is acute coronary syndrome or cardiac failure or some valvular heart disease or other aspects. So that is important. Post-op patients, you will get so many questions from the post-operative areas and toxicology. So this cardiac, post-op and toxicology, you will get so many questions from this area. Other, definitely there are other topics like respiratory, infectious disease or other protocol driven. In it. So these questions will be relatively less number. Yeah. So that question may be relatively less in number. So about that topic selection as well as coverage of topics should be accordingly. You should divide the time for these particular topics also. And I think this is the way you can go forward. And I hope this. Basically EDIC part one preparatory course from Farz Academy will definitely help you, and with this I wish all of you to have a good luck for this appearing exam. And if there is any questions that you can ask me, so I can give, I will try to answer your questions or queries from this mentorship or whatever orientation you are going through. Okay, with this, I thanks. And you have questions, please look forward. Then I will give. I have one question about the liver transcription has been enabled. Who can see that? Okay. Sorry, if you have any questions, please just let me know. Then I can answer one or two questions. No issues. Hello.
Aspirants, any questions, query, if you need to resolve right now, you can. You need to ask with Dr. Sauren Panja, sir. Anything, it could be anything regarding this EDIC one.
So if there is no question, certain areas, basically, if I have 1 or 2 minutes, then I can hear. So in cardiology part, you will get so many questions. There will be ECG depiction and also echocardiography. Right now, there may be small video clip also. So that sometimes, okay, maybe in the questions also. And then there are hemodynamics, basically the whether this is a dynamic fluid responsiveness and other static parameters also may be given. Till now, there are certain parameters that can come from your cardiac output or even the PA catheter, though we are not using much, but PA catheter or other non-invasive monitoring, particularly for the cardiac output, SBRI, SBIE, like say right now, it is EV1000 or EV hemosphere related. So there are certain dynamic parameters that can be given accordingly, that the questions may come from those areas. And acute coronary syndrome, please go through that area. There are sometimes you will get acute coronary syndrome as well as acute decompensated cardiac failure. So these are the cardiology part that you will get questions. And in the post-op period, you will get from any post-op, particularly the general post-operative patients, as well as sometimes thoracic or cardiac post-operative patient, as well as neuro post-op. So post-op neurology is another area where you will get this type of questions. And post-op year, there are so many things about the fluid responsiveness, about the fluid therapy, what kind of fluid you will give, then analgesia part and other complications that usually happen. That complications are usually specific to a particular operations that may also come to your in your questions. And mostly these questions may come in your K-type questions, that in the post-op year. And toxicology, toxicology in this EDIC exam, there are so many questions will come from the toxicology. And very common toxins that is usually like paracetamol, amitriptyline poisoning, calcium channel blocker, these are very common here. So you may get questions from this area. So before exam, actually, you can divide accordingly. So what are the usual toxins that may come in your EDIC exam? So this is the way you can prepare your prepare before actually appearing in the exam. So I think this is what I want to tell you about this preparation of the exam, as well as I hope that this may help you. So if there is no question, then I can conclude my session, and then I will I will hand it over to the original. Okay, here. Okay, thank you.